For some details, I show first the automated tape laying of composites. This is a well-known process in the aerospace industry. Narrow bands of unidirectional prepreg materials, tapes, are placed by a robot in any direction the designer wishes. The process can be automated, and usually prepregs are used. These are tacky and will stick to the molds or to previous layers. To improve tackiness, often local heat is applied. The size of the products can be very large. Think about wing skins from root to tip for big aircraft. Limits to the size are the dimensions of the autoclave used for curing, for the curing process, or the time to lay up the product. If this becomes too long, quality issues may arise. The finished part is vacuum bagged and cured in an autoclave, a pressure vessel at high temperature and pressure. The high temperatures are for speeding up the curing process, the high pressure to compact the layup, and to minimize the porosity in the voids. Automated tape laying has several advantages. First, the robot is able to place the fibers more accurately, resulting in quality improvement and better mechanical properties. Also, the differences between identical parts is less, so it offers a high repeatability. On the other hand, automated tape laying has high investment costs. Nevertheless, the process is used more and more for all kind high-end products, in particular in the aerospace industry. In the picture you see a tape laying process. Note the beam of light indicating local heating to improve the tackiness of the tape. The second process I show is the vacuum infusion process. This process is simple. Dry fibers are placed on a mold, a rigid and solid die, providing the shape of the part. Then the fiber stack is covered with a foil, being the second half of the die, and the part is sealed. Now a vacuum pump extracts all the air in the vacuum bag, and the resin is infused in the fibrous materials, and the resin flows driven by the pressure between the inlet and the outlets. Once the whole fiber package is impregnated, the process is stopped and allowed to cure. Parts are sometimes put in an oven to accelerate the curing process. The vacuum in the bag reduces the occurrence of entrapped air, like voids and porosity, and the pressure difference compacts the fibrous materials. The ease of the infusion process depends, among others, on the fiber directions in the product and the viscosity of the resin. Since the pot life of most resins is about 1 to 2 hours, this is the time limit in which the process should be completed. Vacuum infusion can be used for many different parts. In this slide you see two examples. The vacuum infusion process offers the possibility to infuse large components, like wind turbine blades and ship hulls, like the hull of a yacht in the left picture. In the picture you see a kind of nerve system, a red line in the center and white lines towards the edges. These indicate so-called runners, open channels to facilitate and speed up the infusion process. The infusion starts at these channels, visibly with the dark areas next to these lines. The second example is smaller and is an aircraft component. The aircraft is the Euro NR Eaglet, a two-seater aircraft made of composites, and the part is the rudder. Vacuum infusion processes are not yet certified for primary structures in civil aircraft. Main reason is the difficulty to achieve a high quality due to the relative low pressure during processing. This has its impact on the porosity, compaction, and fiber volume content. The third process I will show is press forming of thermoplastic composites. The material to work with are prepregs, fibers embedded with thermoplastic polymer, or flat laminates. In the latter case, several prepregs are processed into a flat laminate. Since thermoplastics can be reheated and reshaped over and over again, this process also starts with heating of the laminate or prepreg. Then the material is transferred to a press with matching dies, and the material is press formed into shape. Since the heating and cooling can be done in minutes, the cycle time of this process is rather short, 5 to 10 minutes. During the process, high temperatures and pressures are required. High pressures because the viscosity, even at high temperatures, remains rather high, putty-like. The ability of repetitive heating and cooling also allows thermal welding. If two thermoplastic composite parts are joined together, local heating, pressurization, and cooling down can create a local bond when the thermoplastic resin of both parts fuse together locally. On the pictures on the right, you see press formed thermoplastic composite ribs for a flap. Note that in this case, the design is much like a metal design. For press forming of thermoplastic composites, hot presses are needed like the one in the picture. During the process, a significant pressure of more than 10 bar is needed, which doesn't permit to manufacture very large parts like wind turbine blades. Another limit is the sheet thickness. Most polymers are good thermal isolating materials. When the thickness becomes larger, it also becomes more difficult to heat and cool down the composite fast.